On 26th of April 1986, an event took place that is regarded as the most disastrous nuclear power plant accident in history, both in terms of cost and casualties. It is one of only two nuclear energy accidents classified as a level 7 event, the maximum classification on the International Nuclear Event Scale, the other being the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear disaster in Japan in 2011. It officially killed 31 people and left a known number of people affected for the rest of their lives. This is a short documentary on the Chernobyl nuclear disaster, which caused a 19 miles radius safely uninhabitable for humans for another 20,000 years. So grab your headphones, sit back, and let's get right into it. On March 1970, construction of the Chernobyl nuclear power plant located near the city of Chernobyl, Pripyat in northern Ukraine begins. In 1977, the first of the nuclear power plant's four reactors is ready to operate, followed by number two in 1978. In 1982, a partial core meltdown occurs in reactor number one, but the extent of the accident was not made public until 1985, and the reactor was then repaired and put back into operation within months. By 1983, four nuclear reactors are built and the plant becomes operational and was powering nearly 10% of Ukraine's electricity. Now fast forward to the early hours of 26th of April 1986, 16 years after the plant's commission. Workers at the nuclear plant are carrying a test in nuclear reactor number 4. There are many inaccuracies and faults, and the test violated regulation, and this combined with the flawed design in the reactor caused a sudden power surge and an emergency shutdown was implemented. But this failed and workers could feel that something bad was coming, and seconds later this man's hand was located when he helped carrying him out. The officials were slow to react. They were in fact in denial that any radiation was leaking out. Actually, the radiation level was maxing out on their meters, but the max out limit that these meters were capable of showing was nothing worth of evacuating the area. But of course, in reality, the level of radiation was beyond their meters and was astronomically high. In the nearby town of Pripyat, the people were told that it was just a fire at the power plant. Everything was under control and they have nothing to worry about. So life was normal. Children went to school and residents went to work, completely unaware of the invisible radiation they are being exposed to. The levels of radiation were 15,000 times higher than usual and was continuously rising. There is also a story that just after the explosion, many locals gathered on a railway bridge to have a good view of the nuclear plant. And it is said that they witnessed bright, colorful flames coming out from the reactor, but they had no idea that they were exposed to a lethal dose of radiation, and apparently no one survived, and the bridge is now referred to as the Bridge of Death. Now I indeed went deep into this story and found that the bridge does exist, and if people would have been stood there for long enough, then definitely they would have exposed to a deadly level of radiation. But this story is still not yet confirmed. Reactor number 4 was still burning and both heat and radiation level were continuously increasing. So to control the situation, pilots were brought in to fly helicopters above the reactor. About 1800 helicopter flights deposited over 5000 metric tons of sand, lead, clay and neutron absorbing boron onto the burning reactor. The residents were now ordered to evacuate, and an 18 mile area around the power plant was closed, and the residents were given a 2-hour notice to gather their belongings. With the help of 1200 buses, the evacuation took nearly 3.5 hours. People were told that they will be returning in a few days, but this never happened. Around 43,000 people who once called Pripyat their home now were forced atomic refugees, the title that they never imagined being given. The only people left in the area was one old man who refused to evacuate and was found dead in his home just a few weeks later. And the military and scientific delegates who were tasked with getting the still burning reactor under control. They were living unprotected in local hotels, seemingly unaware of the dangerous threat from the high level of radiation. Days after the explosion, clouds of radioactive matter was blown north, drifting over Russia and reaching as far as Sweden. Despite radioactive dust raining on Stockholm, there was no official reports outside the Soviet Union. It took nearly 3 days for the rest of the world to know about this, and this incident coincided with the report that US spy satellite had spotted the wreckage of the burning Chernobyl plant. By now, the whole Europe was at risk of contamination. The plant was still burning and something had to be done to urgently put out the fire and seal reactor number 4 to prevent any more radiation from spilling out. After constant effort, the flames were brought somewhat under control, but the heat was still there, which was causing the base of the reactor to crack. The workers knew that below the reactor was a water reservoir and also a basement that would have been filled with water from firefighters' water hoses. If the radioactive magma contacts with the pool of water underneath, then this would cause a massive steam explosion, throwing out more radioactive material from the reactor into the air. Therefore, it was absolutely necessary to drain this water out. By doing so, another explosion could be prevented and the area below the ground then could be filled with liquid nitrogen to cool it. 3 plant workers volunteered for this mission. Among those 3 brave men, one knew where the valves were located and other 2 had the job to hold a submersible light. Their light failed almost immediately and they were forced to proceed in complete darkness, often under highly radioactive water to find the valves. They opened the valves and returned back, but sadly all died shortly after from the radiation, something they knew would happen as a result of their heroic feat. The explosion would have been so catastrophic that would have put whole Europe's existence at risk. With the situation somewhat under control and the threat of explosion eliminated and averted, the workers set out to wash the radioactive dust off the street and to seal out the reactor to minimize the spread of radiation. A large concrete enclosure named the sarcophagus was built on the site. Access points were left in the sarcophagus for researchers. During one such research trip, their equipment registered levels of radiation so high that it would kill anyone who got too close for more than a few seconds. In order to see what was causing the readings, the scientists attached a camera to a wheeled contraption and rolled it in the direction the readings were emanating. What they saw was dubbed the elephant's foot. The elephant's foot is so deadly that spending only 30 seconds near it will result in dizziness and fatigue. 2 minutes near it and your cells will begin to hemorrhage. By the time you hit the 5-minute mark, you are gone. Even after 30 years, the foot is still melting through the concrete base of the power plant. Its existence makes the city uninhabitable to humans for at least next 100 years. If it's melted down to a source of groundwater, it would contaminate the water of nearby villages or even trigger another explosion. But according to current situation, it is far likely to happen. The sarcophagus was built by December 1986, 8 months after the disaster, and it covered the whole reactor. It is thought to be that nearly 800,000 people risked their lives in 1986 in an attempt to contain and clean up the Chernobyl disaster site. Many of these brave people received medals for their work, but sadly 28 people died because of acute radiation sickness in the weeks after the initial explosion. The Chernobyl disaster initially took life of 2 workers, followed by 29 people later due to radiation-related deaths, and 4 men from an helicopter that crashed trying to contain the fire at the plant. Millions of people were affected by its long-term effects, but the exact figure is still unknown. Many people still bear the effects of the disaster and the memories are still very real to this day. The exclusion zone now covers an area of 1,000 miles around the power plant. Although many live at this area at their own risk, mainly workers who are currently building a new safe confinement over the sarcophagus for containing the radioactive remains of reactor 4 for next 100 years. The towns near Pripyat and many other areas close to the reactor are just ghost towns. Nobody ever returned to live there and haunted images show how life must have changed that day. But one surprising fact about the area surrounding Chernobyl is its ever-growing wildlife. Initially, it was thought that the disaster will have a devastating effect on local wildlife, creating to form alien-like radioactive creatures and many animals would disappear from the area around the power plant. But recent studies have shown that deer, elk, wolves and wild boars seems relatively unaffected by the contaminated land. Although some animals have showed deformities after the event and some population have decreased, but it's nowhere near what was being predicted. In total, this accident costed Soviet Union nearly £200 billion and drove millions from their homes, making it the biggest and most disastrous nuclear power plant accident in history. So this was a short documentary about the Chernobyl nuclear disaster. With this video, I tried to cast some light on what actually happened in those horrific dark days in and around the Chernobyl power plant and how those three people lost their lives in an attempt to save billions of other people. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, do hit that like button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon after subscribing. Thanks for watching, and I will see you on the internet.